Question in this video, transformers and bipolar transistors, do they match? Well, is it possible to connect a transformer to, for instance, a grounded emitter transistor circuit? Well, that's quite a problem. The reason is that the input impedance of a grounded emitter transistor circuit is very low, say 10,000 ohms or 5,000 ohms. Of course, that's an ohms indication, and we know, of course, that impedance is a complex resistance consisting of capacitive and resistive and even inductive elements. But anyway, it's a good rule of thumb to think that a grounded emitter circuit has an impedance, a resistance at its input from, say, 5,000 ohms or 10,000 ohms. There are circuits where you can change that, for instance, by bootstrapping. And the bootstrap circuit is absolutely sure on the World Wide Web. I don't publish it here because of the aim of this video. And that's the question, whether transformers and bipolar transistors can match in an easy way. Well, that's not the case. The better circuit is, of course, the triode tube, the electron tube. The impedance between the grid and the zero or the minus is very, very high, and that means that the coil is not damped. So when it has its peak resonance on, say, 400 kilohertz, the tube does not have any effect on that peak resonance. It doesn't push the resonance down, making the circuit less sensitive at its input. The same is the case in this situation. The field effect transistor, the BF245 for instance, not a MOSFET but a normal NFET in this case. When you connect a coil to the gate of a normal standard NFET, the BF245 for instance, there's almost no damping of the coil, and the coil holds its peak resonance to which it is tuned. And that also means that we have an ideal situation here to receive radio signals between, say, 100 kHz and 30 MHz. Tuned coil to that frequency, no damping. The coil holds its very good properties, etc. And here that's a problem because of the diode junction here. When you connect here, for instance, a coil, could be an IF filter or such a coil or this coil, and here all kinds of filters with the corresponding frequencies for which they were made. You can read that from the color of the core. Red, for instance, means a filter or a coil for 1.3 megahertz, megacycles, etc., etc. But when you try to connect such a coil to a grounded emitter circuit, the results are in general disappointing. on the World Wide Web, by the way, and in circuits from the 1960s and 1970s, you often see this circuit, because in those days the field effect transistor was not very common. So they tried to do their best with connecting here, for instance, a radio coil with an antenna. And of course, such a transistor can amplify very much, say 300 times. So there were more or less quite good results, but the best results are given, made with this circuit, the field effect transistor, or the triode tube. So let's go back here to that circuit. It's in my books, and I try to make here I try to use here a transistor as a coupling element, and of course such a transistor, transformer as a coupling element, and every transformer has a certain frequency where it performs best. Here IF transformers and shortwave transformers. Here a transformer that works best on say 50 hertz or 60 hertz. I tested it and it also works very good on 300 hertz. It has a kind of peak resonance on 300 hertz, these transformers. And of course here all these transformers have their specific frequencies where they give out their maximum energy in case of the situation when they are used in an oscillator. But in fact radio reception has also to do with that. In radio reception we talk about frequencies in a certain frequency band, could be short wave or medium wave, and the ideal situation is that a coil for a radio receiver has a good peak, is sensitive on a certain frequency band, and that's here the same. And this circuit was developed to be used as a kind of IF amplifier. And you can see here that there is a kind of solution to solve the problems of damping, etc., and biasing. The transformer coil is here connected in the collector lead of the first transistor. And the secondary of this tuned circuit is connected here in the base lead. So we have at the same time two problems solved: the biasing from these two transistors that is usable, and you can you can change it, align it to the best situation by tuning this potentiometer here, and also the bias of the first transistor. You can set it to its proper working point when the signal enters here to the base of the first transistor. And on the other hand, we have the situation that we can get this coil into its proper resonance. Of course, not always. That has everything to do with the properties of the transistors, etc., etc. But this is more or less a circuit that is usable frequencies between, say, 20 kilohertz or 10 kilohertz and, say, 500 kilohertz. You can, of course, do experiments, try to get it to a higher frequency, say 700 kilohertz or 1 megahertz. Of course, with on 1 megahertz, this will be must be a high frequency circuit, and the properties of high frequency circuits differ somewhat. Anyway, it's a good circuit to make, for instance, to use a coil as a coupling device. Frequency dependent coupling device. When you use here, for instance, a capacitor directly here from the collector to the emitter, there's no frequency dependence. A coil is always a frequency dependent unit, and when you want to make it make this unit more sharp, you can use here small capacitors in the 100 picofarad up to 1 nanofarad range. Amplification is set here. This amplification can be set to a very high value. Of course, these capacitors play a role. Use, for instance, 50 nanofarad or 100 nanofarad for frequencies between 10 kilohertz and, say, 700 kilohertz. And here more tips. And much more information is in my books, and this circuit is from one of my books. So, that was more or less all to tell. Again, the triode tube has a very high input impedance. The field effect transistor exactly the same. The grounded emitter circuit has a low input impedance resistance. And you can see, for instance, in high frequency situations, say between 100 megahertz and say 400 megahertz in old school circuits, the grounded base circuit is used. That has somewhat better properties for high frequency amplification. Beautiful coils, all kinds of transformers for all kinds of frequencies tuned to a certain frequency band with a bandwidth of, say, 5 kilohertz or 10 kilohertz, etc.